And good morning from Mission Control Houston, and welcome to today's International Space Station update. Joining us here inside of the flight control room at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas, looking over as the Orbit 2 team is monitoring all these systems on board the orbiting laboratory. Today's team is being led by veteran flight director Paul Dye, and joining him at the CAPCOM position is Anna Fisher. She'll be serving as the communication link between all of our teams down here on the ground and the astronauts up in space. Those astronauts right now are the crew of Expedition 34. They're being led by NASA astronaut Kevin Ford, and he is joined by three Russian cosmonauts, one Canadian, and one fellow NASA astronaut, Kevin Ford, there in the front row on the left. Behind him, Russian cosmonauts OLEG and Evgeny Tarelkin, who joined with Ford on board the International Space Station back in October. And then there on the right, we have our three newest station crew members, Russian cosmonaut Roman Romanenko, Canadian astronaut Chris Hadfield, and NASA astronaut Tom Marshburn. Very busy day as work is in full swing on board the International Space Station, starting off with Commander Kevin Ford, who a little bit earlier this morning was performing a monthly periodic fitness evaluation. He was doing that on the station's SEVIS device, which is the cycle ergometer with isolation stabilization. It's one of the stationary cycle bikes on board that is used for exercise by these astronauts, doing that fitness evaluation as they constantly monitor their health during their six-month increments on board the station. Aside from that, Commander Ford was working on the combustion integrated rack, doing some hardware gather for some upcoming experiments. Following that, and a little bit later in this hour, he'll be doing a ham radio pass using a traditional ham radio, much like those found on the ground down here, talking to some participants at the Missoula Family YMCA in Missoula, Montana. Meanwhile, Russian cosmonaut Oleg Novitsky was emptying out the soft tank over in the Russian portion of the International Space Station. He was also working to open up some of the holes in the partitions near the Russian service module, also known as VESDA, working to run a few cables for the eventual mini laboratory module's integration with the rest of the station structure. His colleague, Russian cosmonaut Evgeny Tarelkin, was doing some cleaning work throughout the Russian segment today, cleaning off some of the panel vent screens throughout the air revitalization system inside of the station systems, also cleaning out some of the dust filters and replacing those inside of the mini research module 1, also known as Rosviet, where the Soyuz TMA-07M spacecraft is currently docked. They'll also be doing a few routine replacements on the Russian toilet system. Our third Russian cosmonaut, Roman Romanenko, again, who just joined the station crew back in December, is working on the plasma crystal experiment today. It's a fairly complex look into studying the growth of plasma dust structures in zero gravity. This study also looks at particle cloud behavior and internal flow structures inside of these plasma dust crystals. He'll also be joining with Evgeny Tarelkin in their ongoing efforts to make a documentary about life on board the International Space Station being done for Russian agencies. Our Canadian astronaut Chris Hadfield was in his second day of collecting biological samples for the Human Research Facility, taking blood and urine samples and then storing them in one of the cryogenic freezers on board the International Space Station. He'll also be running the InSpace 3 experiment. InSpace, a fairly long acronym standing for Investigating the Structure of Paramagnetic Aggregates from Colloidal Emulsions. This another fairly complex study taking advantage of that microgravity environment, looking to obtain data on fluids that contain ellipsoid-shaped particles that then change their physical properties of the fluids that they're in response to magnetic fields. And our final Expedition 34 crew member Tom Marshburn, another NASA astronaut, was working with the environmental health system on board the station, setting up some acoustic dosimeters, which measure noise loads throughout the station structure. He was also working in the internal thermal control system, doing an install of a maintenance canister.